Hi guys, I am Inna Alexandrovna Dronovskaya and today we learn English together again. And that's awesome, guys. And what are we going to talk about today? It's conditional sentences. And the first thing that we need to learn is what is conditional. So I'd like you to look at the first sentence. If I see Tim, I will invite him to the party. So, as you see, it's complicated sentences, and it consists of two sentences. The first one is, if I see Tim, and the second one is, I will invite him to the party. And as you see, the first one, if I see Tim, it's if clause or if sentence. And the second one, I will invite him to the party, it's the main sentence. Now look at the second one. I will invite Tim to the party if I see him. What do you think? Are these sentences the same? Yes, they mean the same. But why do they look different? If you look at the second sentence, you can see that I will invite Tim to the party. It's the main one. And after it, you can see if I see him, it's if sentence. So, as you see, these sentences are completely the same and they mean the same, but they look different because in the first one you can see if sentence in the first place and then main clause. In the second one you can see main clause in the first one and if clause as the second sentence. And if you put if sentence in the first place, you need to put comma. But if you have the main clause in the beginning, you don't have to put comma. Okay, guys, there are four types of conditionals, of conditional sentences. And the first one is zero conditional. And the first thing that the first question that you can ask me is, when do we have to use these type of sentences? And we use zero conditional if we talk about general truth or different scientific facts. Look at the sentence. If you heat ice, it melts. Now let's find the verbs in these two parts of the sentences. If you heat ice, heat is the verb. It melts. Melts is a verb. Okay, as you see in the if sentence, you use present simple, and in main sentence, you use present simple too. So, look at the next sentence. If animals don't drink water, they die. It's scientific fact or general truth. And this sentence is negative. If you don't drink water, if animals don't drink water, they die. And look at the last sentence. Unless animals drink water, they die. Are these sentences, two sentences, the same? Yes, they mean the same. But in the first one, in negative conditional, you use don't. But in the second one, you use unless instead of don't. And pay attention, if you use don't, after it, you use a verb in the first form. If you use unless, you use the verb drink in the first form, but you don't have to use negative form because unless has a negative meaning. And now let's focus on form. How do we form zero conditional? If sentence is present simple, and main sentence is in present simple too. So present simple plus present simple. Example, if you press this button, if sentence press is in present simple, computer starts working. Starts, it's present simple too. Okay then, the second type of conditional, it has the name real conditional number one, and we usually use such kind of sentences when we want to express the real possibility that refers to the present or to the future. And examples again. If you finish this work, we goes out. If you finish this work, we will go out. What do you think? What is correct sentence? Do you think the first one is correct? Of course, no. The second one is correct. And now again, look at if sentence. If you finish this work, a verb finish, we will go out. The main sentence, will go out. Let's think about the constructions. In the if sentence, we use present simple finish, but in the main clause, we use future simple, will go. And again, let's look back at negative one with the word unless. Unless you finish this work, or if you don't finish this work, we won't go out. And now let's focus on form again. How do we form real conditional number one? In if sentence, we use present simple. In main clause, we use future simple, and the main verb will. For example, if you finish this work, finish is in present simple. We will go out. Main clause, will go out, is a future simple. And now, half real conditional, and it's conditional number two. We usually use such kind of conditional sentences if we want to talk about an imaginary situation that also refer to the present or future. Again, two sentences to compare and to find the mistakes. If we used bicycles, we will save our planet. Or if we used bicycles, we would save our planet. What is the correct one? Of course, the second one. And let's look at the construction. If we used bicycles, if sentence, let's find the main verb, used, it's past simple, the second form of the verb. We would save our planet. And would save is future in the past, would instead of will. And again, negative one. Unless we used bicycles, we wouldn't save our planet. Or if we didn't use bicycles, we wouldn't save our planet. And the next one, we have to focus on the construction of half-real conditionals or conditional number two. So, as you see, in if sentence, we use past simple or the second form of the verb. And in the main clause, we use future in the past and the would instead of will. For example, if I were you, were is past simple. And remember one thing, that all pronouns need were, but not was. If I were you, if she were me, if he were me, and so on. I would invite him to the party. Would is future in the past instead of will. And the last type of conditional is unreal conditional or conditional number three. We usually use them in an impossible situations in the past or if we want to talk about the regret about past. And again, two sentences. If I go out last night, I would watch a sunset. Or if I had gone out last night, I would have watched a sunset. Of course, the second sentence is correct. If I had gone out last night, it's if sentence. Let's look at the grammar construction. Had gone, what tense is it? Of course, it's past perfect. And look at the main one. I would have, and participle number three, or verb in the third form. So, and again, negative one. Unless I hadn't gone out, so I wouldn't have watched sunset. Do you think this sentence is correct? Unless, and I hadn't gone out. Is it possible? Of course not. Unless I had gone out, I wouldn't have watched sunset. Okay, guys, and now let's focus on form two. Unreal conditional number three. In if sentence, we use past perfect. And in the main clause, we use would plus have and plus participle number two or verb in the third form. And example, if I had called you, You would have come to my birthday party. I had called is past perfect, and would have, and the verb in the third form or participle number two. Okay, guys, and now let's practice. And remember, if you practice more, your English will be fantastic. In the first activity, guys, you have to remember the functions of conditionals. And now let's put them into correct place. Zero conditional, first conditional, second conditional, or the third conditional. Okay, describe a situation that don't happen and to imagine the result of this situation. What do you think? Is it zero, first, second, or third conditional? Let's think a situation that didn't happen and to imagine the result of the situation. It might be conditional number two. Okay, give instructions using the imperative and in the main clause. It might be zero conditional. Let it be zero conditional. Describe a future situation that are impossible or unlikely in reality. Let it be the second one. The first one or the second one. Let it be. Describe a future situation we believe are real or possible. Are real or possible. Let it be first one. It's a real conditional. General truths, scientific facts, of course it's 0-1. Scientific facts, it's 0-1. And habits, they are 0-1 too. Okay, so the third conditional, we haven't got it. Let's find, maybe we have a mistake, let's find. Describe future situations that are impossible and unlikely in reality. It might be the third one. And now let's check. We have mistakes. Second and the third one. Let's find the correct answers. Show the answers as you see. Okay. So, second conditional. Of course, they describe a future situation that are impossible or unlikely in reality. And the third one, they didn't happen. And to imagine the result of the situation. Okay, guys. Let's do the next one. In the second activity, you have to look at them. And in this one, you have to put the conditionals into three groups. Zero conditional, first conditional, second conditional. And of course, you have to identify the verbs in these parts of the sentences. If I were you, I would eat less chocolate. Were you and would eat. Of course, it's the second one. If you take these pills, you will start to feel better. Take and will. It's the first one. If she is late, I will go without her. She is, I will go. Of course, it's the first one. If it is dangerous if you don't wear. Is dangerous and don't wear. 0-1. If you heat water, it boils. Heat and boils. General truth or scientific fact. It's zero conditional. If my legs were longer, I would be a faster. Were longer and I would be. It's the second one. I would buy a house if I had more money. I would buy if I had the first. If you don't feel well, you won't go. It's the first one. If you send an email, it's free. Sent. It's free. It's the first one. Okay. If you have an injection, it doesn't. Okay. And so on, so forth, guys. Now, guys, I think it's time to finish. It's time to finish. And I would like to tell you thank you very much. See you next time. Bye-bye.